Anything new coming in with the damage reports? What are you hearing now to the east?
Well, you know what I'm mainly hearing are damage reports out of Alamance County, also out of Randolph County, and those communities have some of the strongest winds in our area right now as the storm is pulling away, as you mentioned, very quickly. And most of the reports that we've seen, if you look at our damage report map, we have had flooding over Wilkes, Surrey County, points north and west. And of course, Leanne Daniel reporting on some of the flooding there. And then it's been wind damage starting in Yakin County up into parts of Stokes County, and then all the Triad communities having wind report damages. So you can see there in Harmony, a 60-mile-per-hour wind gust was reported there in the northwestern part of Davie County. Those are severe thunderstorm-type wind gusts, so it's no surprise that if you get that type of wind gust widespread across the area, you're going to have a number of trees down. I've got reports on my Facebook page of, hey, it looks like a bomb went off in my neighborhood. There's trees down everywhere. And that's sort of the current theme that I'm hearing from a lot of folks out there. You can see a 62-mile-per-hour wind gust there reported in the Yadkinville area, and also downtown Yadkinville on Main Street. They've got power out, by the way. They also have three large oak trees that are down across Main Street. So trees are blocking roadways and pathways. If you do have to get out, expect that there will be delays. We're, of course, encouraging you not to go out because we could still have more trees down into the afternoon. Multiple trees down on homes in Davidson County. That is a general statement coming from emergency management because they just have so many cases right now that they're having to deal with. Also, now the latest statement out of Forsyth County, multiple trees down across Forsyth County, trees on cars, trees that have caused power outages reported all across Forsyth County. And then out of Alamance County, we're getting reports too in the Elon College area, particularly hard hit. You can see that we have a tree down in a home there at College Avenue in North Oak. We also have a report of multiple trees down across Elon University. So that's usually the blanket statement that is given when they just want to make sure that we can get the word out to you, but there's so many cases that they can't report each individual one. Wind gusts in Alamance reported at 51 miles per hour, a tree down on the home on Highway 70 in Mebane. Remember, the safest place to be in your home is on the lowest floor. You want to be mindful of any trees you have out in your yard that may come down. Make sure you're not in the rooms that are located near that. I know that sounds really, really stressful and may cause a lot of anxiety, but we just want to try to keep you safe. And that is good advice this afternoon, because you can see the tree reports back through Alamance County south and west. And we've had wind gusts that have been anywhere between 50 and 60 miles an hour from Charlotte to the Triad, and now it's starting to move into the Raleigh area. We're going to anticipate our winds to be up this afternoon. The core of the strongest winds have already moved through, so that's good news. But still, with wind gusts at 30 to 50 miles an hour this afternoon, we could have more trees down. I'll be in later this evening. We're going to talk about a slight chance that we might have some thunderstorms roll through the Eastern Triad between about 8 p.m. and about 11 p.m. tonight. So I'll be back with more on that, of course, coming up later. Michelle and I will have your coverage this afternoon. I'm going to send it back to the studio.